Hey everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are learning about how we can add social login to our WordPress website. And before we proceed with the tutorial, please subscribe my channel, like and comment. Okay, let's proceed with the tutorial now. So first we will go to the dashboard, assuming you are already logged in. Now we will add a new plugin. Plugin name is Super Socializer. That's the plugin which we'll be installing. Install the plugin. Okay, let's activate the plugin now. Now we will go to social login. And enable the social login here. Once enabled, hit save changes. And now we will start with the Google. Let's select the Google. Hit save changes. And now as you can see that it's asking for the secret keys. Now we will generate the Google client ID and Google client secret by using the developer console. Let's go to that. So once you open the developer console, you will see the new project option. We're gonna create new project. Let's name it social login and create the project. Here we have our new project ready. Now we're gonna go to OAuth screen. And from there on, we will select external, click on create. Let's add an application name as social login. No need for logo at the moment. On authorized domain, we will add our website URL. So here's the domain, hit save. And then we'll go to credentials. And now we will click create credentials and then OAuth client ID. Now application type is web application because we're using it on our web. On authorized redirect URIs, we will add our URL. And we have our URL. Let's hit create. Okay, we have our client ID and client secret. Now we have to update it here. Let's copy it. Now let's do the same for client secret. I hit save changes. Okay, after saving the changes, we will check it on incognito window to see if we are seeing the login option. Let's copy the URL. Open the incognito window. Okay, now we'll go to the backend to check if you're seeing the login option. Here we have our login with Google. Now let's try logging in. Okay. I'm gonna log in using this ID. Okay, I'm successfully logged in. There we go. Woohoo! I'm successfully logged in. Now let's check out the email to see if I have received a new user email. So I'm gonna go to my Gmail. Okay, as you can see, it created the new user with the social login. Okay, now let's check it on our product page if the login with Google is showing up there or not. Let's go to the shop. I have added a dummy product here for you guys to show. Let's click on that. Add this product to cart. View cart. Let's go to the checkout. Okay, here we will see login with Google. So I'm gonna enable the setting on the plugin for that. Let's go to the dashboard and plugin settings. Super Socializer, social login. And then advanced configuration. Now I'm gonna enable it for WooCommerce. Enable at WooCommerce checkout page. Hit save changes. Now let's go to the checkout page again and see if it's visible here. And now we can see here, we can see login with our social ID. And let's click on that. Now after logging in with social login, you can see it automatically pull up my email address. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna complete the profile from the backend to see if it's pulling up all the details. Now let's go to the backend and fill up the profile details. I'm gonna add to the users. And here's the user which is created. Now let's add it and fill up all the details here. Let's add first name, last name is already there. Let's add website as test.com. Company name test company. Test address 1. Test address 2. Test city. Zip postal code. Add a country. State, phone number, let's put a dummy phone number for now. Copy all the billing details from the above. Now hit update user. Now let's go back to this, to the checkout page, and hit refresh. There we go. It pulled up all of the details which were required. Cool. We are done with the Google login. Now we will proceed with the Facebook social login. Let's go to the plugin settings, social login. And we will enable the Facebook. Hit save changes. And now it's asking for the secret key similar to the Google. Now we will go to the Facebook developer. It's developers.facebook.com. Just navigate to that. I'm already logged in to Facebook. You will have to log in. You will see the login button here. I'm seeing my apps. So after logging in, you will see this screen where you will see the apps. And then you will create, add a new app. Click on for everything else. And just add in my email address. App display name, we can set it as social login. Create app ID. Here we see the type of Facebook app which we need to create. We're gonna click on Facebook login setup. Click here. And then we will select web. Now here we will add our site URL. Hit save. Once save, we'll go to settings, then basic. Here we have our app ID and app secret. Let's copy that to our plugin settings. App ID. Secret, show. Hit submit. And now we can see our app secret. Let's copy it, paste it to the plugin settings. Hit save changes. And now it shows that we need to add this URL to valid OAuth redirect URLs. Let's copy that. We will go to Facebook login, click settings, and paste the URL here. Here we go. Hit save changes. And click here to now it's giving an, when we add it in the production mode, it's showing up that we have an invalid policy URL. We're gonna go to basic settings and add in our privacy policy page. So I've already created the privacy policy page. And we're gonna just put the URL for that page from here. It's in the draft mode, so let's publish it first. Okay, let's publish the page. Now copy this URL and paste it on the Facebook privacy policy URL here. Once done, hit save changes. Choose a category here. I'm gonna select shopping for now. Hit save changes again. Now select for the production. Switch mode. And here we go. Our Facebook app is live now. Now we're gonna test the Facebook login similar how we did the Google login test. Let's go back to the incognito window. Okay, let's go back to the backend again. And from here we can see login with the Facebook. Now click on that. Now now it's asking me to log in. Let's log in to the Facebook. Try login again. Now I have two-factor authentication enabled. Let me accept it from my mobile device. And I just tap the yes from my mobile. Now it's proceeding. Let's continue as below. Okay, we are successfully logged in. Let's go to the shop and see if we have any information showing up there. Ebook. Add to cart. Proceed to checkout. Here we go. It's pulling up my name and my email. And that's it for the tutorial. I hope you guys like it. Let me know in the comments if you have any difficulty integrating Facebook and Google login. Thank you. Have a great day.